how to write regular program. Basic. Regular. Let's see. So this is my topic today. Okay? So basically we have HDL means hardware, description, language. Description, language. So in this generally we have two types. One is VHDL and another one is Verilog HDL. So here coming to the VHDL, this can be written as VHSIC HDL. Here VHSIC indicates very high speed integrated circuit. Hardware, description, language. Description, language. So coming to the Verilog HDL, Verilog indicates that this is nothing but verifying logic. Verifying logic, hardware, description, language. So in this, basically how to write a Verilog code, this is our main topic. So Verilog HDL is nothing but the advanced of the VHDL. So as our topic is dependent upon Verilog now, so I will be telling you what are the basic steps to write the Verilog code. I will be telling you. So basic steps here, we need to learn first. To write the Verilog programming, programming means we require what are the inputs and what are the outputs. So here in basic steps, first one we require what are the inputs and how many number of outputs are there. First we have to know that. Then only we can go to the programming part or we can design any circuit. So coming to the second point here. So after knowing the inputs and outputs, what we have to know? We have to know the functionality. So functionality. We have to know the functionality of the circuit, or we can say that it is nothing but logic, that is truth table. Truth table. Or we can call it as, we can know the behavior of the circuit also, we can say. Functionality of the circuit or behavior of the circuit. Truth table we have to know. Coming to the third one, after writing the truth table of the circuit, so what we have to know that after writing the truth table, we have to know the output expression. So what is the output expression? We have to know. So the third one is output expression. So after writing the output expression, so what is the fourth thing? We have to draw the logic diagram. So this is the last step here. So why we are discussing about these basic steps are, so depending upon these four basic steps, we are going to write the program. So to write the programming, we have four levels of modeling. We'll be learning levels of modeling. So what are these levels of modeling means? We have four levels of modeling. First one is gate level modeling, or we can call it as structural level modeling. And coming to the second one, behavioral level modeling. Behavioral level modeling. And coming to the third one, we have data flow modeling. Data flow modeling. And we have the another level of modeling is, that is nothing but switch level. Switch level modeling. And the last one we will be having is mixed level modeling. Mixed level modeling. So when we are writing in gate level modeling or behavioral modeling or data flow or switch level or mixed level, so we have to see with respect to these basic steps. So depending upon these basic steps, we are going to write every level of modeling program. So now, first one, coming to the gate level modeling. So which step leads to the gate level modeling from here, we will be knowing that. So here, coming to the logic diagram. So here, this logic diagram, when you know the logic diagram, we can write this gate level modeling program. That is the first one in the level of modeling. First level of modeling can be written when you know the logic diagram. So coming to the second one. So behavioral level of modeling. So behavioral level of modeling means we have to know the behavior of the particular design. So it means that here functionality. So functionality or behavior indicates the behavioral level modeling. So coming to the second point here, this is leading to the second level of modeling. So if you know the behavior or truth table or functionality of the circuit, then we can write the behavioral level of modeling. So this is the thing. And then coming to the third one, data flow modeling. So what is left over out of these all? So what are the inputs and how many number of outputs? This is a common for each and every level of design data. First step. Coming to the second step, already we have discussed that here. This is depending upon the behavioral level modeling. Second one. And coming to the third one, output expression. So this is only left over. So for writing the data flow level of modeling, so we have to know the output expression. So if you know the output expression, then we can write the data flow modeling. So that is nothing but this is leading to the third level of modeling. So these are the basic steps to write the Verilog program. So now we will be discussing the remember these all steps of basic steps of level of modeling. We have to know all these things. We will be taking a small example and we will be writing the basic program also for this Verilog. So before going to the programming first, you have to remember these all points thoroughly. Okay, now. Now let me take an example here. So example. So I'm going to write the basic program for AND gate. So I'm going to write the two input AND gate program. So coming to the basic program for AND gate, before going to the programming part, let me discuss with the syntax. So I'll be writing the syntax here. Syntax of the Verilog program. So it starts with module, module name of code list. So I'll be discussing this, what are these all, and this here declarations, logic and module. So this is the basic syntax of the program. So here module name is, this is optional. We can give any of the name here as a module name. So module is the start of the program and module is the end of the program here. So coming to the port list. So what is nothing but port list? Port list is nothing but, so here we have discussed in the basic steps, that is what are the inputs and what are the outputs. So there, what are the inputs and what are the outputs we are going to give, that is nothing but the port list here. So it means that we have to give inputs, comma, outputs. Inputs and outputs to be written in the port list. The order of writing is outputs, comma, inputs, that is in the standard manner. So we use the industrial standards of writing the port list, that is outputs comma inputs. We can give it as inputs comma outputs, but we maintain the standards of the industry. Okay, and now coming to the declarations. So declarations means, so we have three types of declarations here. One is input declarations, another one is output declarations, another one is in-out declarations. So what are nothing but these one? So in the basic steps we have discussed what are the inputs. So inputs are all will be discussed with a keyword called input. So input followed by, we will be writing, first suppose we are taking A, B as inputs. We will be writing it as A, comma B. Those are nothing but the input variables. So if I am taking output variables, so output I am taking it as Y. I will be using the keyword called output. Output followed by the output variable. And in-output. So when do you use the in-out variables? So in some cases, a single variable can be used as both input as well as output. So in that respective case, we use the keyword called in-out and we declare with respect to that variable here. So that is the input declarations, output declarations and in-out declarations. So coming to the logic. So coming to the logic, what is nothing but logic here? Logic means, just now I have discussed levels of modeling. So this logic
how to write in these all levels of modeling, I'll tell you. So here, coming to the behavioral modeling, first one. So let me take gate level modeling first. So coming to the gate level modeling, how many number of gates you have basically? So you have basically 7. So first gate is buffer. Buffer is also gate. NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate, NAND, NOR, XOR and XNOR. So these are all gates we have. So buffer, this NOT is an inversion of the buffer. So we can write it as buffer followed by the NOT gate. So buffer means what is nothing but buffer in general. So whatever the input you give, the same will be reflected to the output. So if you give input as X, output value also will be X only. So that is nothing but buffer. NOT means inversion of the buffer. AND gate, you know, AND gate we have the functionality of the AND gate. The inversion of AND gate will be NAND, OR, inversion of OR will be NOR, and XOR, inversion of XOR will be XNOR. So here, in a basic Verilog programming, we use these all gates as a keywords in the gate level modeling. So while writing the programming part, we use these all gate names as a keywords to write the programming. So how to write the programming here? I'm mentioning it here. So here, if I'm writing the AND gate, I'll be taking AND followed by the gate name. That is, as I'm writing the 2 input AND gate, AND 2 followed by port list. That is, what I told you, the output list, outputs comma input. So first suppose I'm taking Y as my output, Y comma A comma B. So this will be your logic for the gate level modeling. So if I write the behavioral modeling, behavioral level. So behavioral level means I need to know the truth table. So coming to the, as we are writing for the AND gate. So what is the truth table of the AND gate here? So A, B, Y. So output expression will be Y is equals to A dot B. This A into B. So for 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So this is a AND gate. So Y is equals to A into B means 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 1, 0, 1 into 0, 0 and 1 into 1, 1. So it means that what is the definition of the AND gate now? So any of the input is 0, any one of the input is 0, output is 0. Or else we can define it as if both the inputs are high, output is high. So you can define the AND gate in any of the manner. So that is nothing but the behavior of the AND gate. So depending upon the truth table, we are going to write the behavioral level of modeling program. So how to write it now? So if any of the input variable is changing, then only we can define the output. So if you don't define A or if you don't define B, we cannot define Y variable. So we don't know the behavior of the design. So depending upon that, we write the behavioral level of modeling. The syntax for this behavioral of level of modeling is the logic I'm writing here. Logic for behavioral level of modeling. So always at the rate. This is nothing but the event control. This is nothing but the event control. Event control means with respect to these variables. What are the, with respect to inputs, output is going to change. So with what event it is going, output is going to change, that is nothing but the event control. So it means that A or B. So we need to write here A comma B. Here. And next we have to write begin. And logic is, what is the output expression? Y is equals to A and B end. So this is the logic of the behavioral level of modeling. So coming to the next, data flow modeling. Data flow modeling means what I told you, depending upon the output expression, we are going to write the data flow modeling. So here, output expression means directly we have the output expression as Y is equals to A and B. But here, what we are going to do, we are going to assign Y as A and B. So it means that we use the keyword called assign for writing the data flow modeling. So this is nothing but data flow modeling, assign Y is equals to A and B. So while writing the program, I'll make you clear what is what. In general, I'm telling you, for writing the logic, we can use any of the logics here. Coming to the switch level, this is nothing but transistor level completely. It means that we use the MOS switches. So for MOS switches, we have NMOS circuits, PMOS circuits, as well as CMOS circuits. So depending upon these also transistor level diagrams, we can write the programming for the switch level modeling. So Coming to the mixed level modeling here, we can write all mixed of all the programs here. So now, next, coming to the program, let us see some small program. So these are the basic things, how to write the program. This is the basic syntax and this is the logic here. So one small program we will be writing very soon here. Module AND2 of, what are the inputs for the AND gate I have taken here? Outputs comma inputs. So input A comma B, output, what I have taken variable Y. And if I am writing the logic in data flow, so what I told you here, assign y is equals to a and b. Here as I am taking the small variables, I will be taking the same thing here and module. So this is the basic level of programming, how to write and all. So for these gates, you will be using the symbols for and ampersand for OR pipeline for X or cap. So for this NOT gate, you will be using the exclamation or exclamatory mark, and for this negation and negation pipeline and negation cap. Thank you.